In this video, I'll show you one way to create an HD Insight cluster using the Windows Azure Management Portal. In less than 15 minutes, I'll have the nodes in my cluster created, my file system and storage configured, and my cluster up and running. HD Insight provides everything I need to quickly deploy Apache Hadoop clusters that run on Windows Azure. HD Insight also provides a cost-efficient approach to the managing and storing of data using Windows Azure Blob Storage. To begin, I log into the Management Portal. On the bottom of the screen, click New. Select Data Services, HD Insight. At this point, I have two choices: Quick Create and Custom Create. The Quick Create option lets me name my cluster, choose from a list of cluster sizes, add a password for the default admin account, and link to an existing storage account. But I want more control over my cluster, so for this video, I'll use Custom Create. I name my cluster Video Cluster. The name I use becomes the address for my cluster in the Azure HDInsight.net domain. 4 nodes is perfect. I don't want to enter more than I need, as this increases the price. And we are going to choose 3.0 that uses Hadoop 2.2 to create the cluster. Selecting the correct data center region is important when I'm creating a cluster to use with an existing Windows Azure storage account. This cluster must be created in the same region that contains the existing storage account. Storing my data and my results in the region where I create my cluster to run my jobs ensures better performance and lower costs. I select West US. Now I'll set up the user account for my cluster. I start by entering the username and then create a password. I'm not using a Metastore, so I ignore the remaining fields. On the next page, I tell HD Insight which storage account to use. One of the many benefits of HD Insight is that I can choose where to store the data that I'll analyze and the data that are created as a result of the analysis. A native HDFS file system stores the data local to the compute nodes in the Hadoop cluster, and an Azure Blob Storage container provides a file system that stores my data in persistent cloud store that is separate from my cluster. Keeping my data separate means that I can set up my cluster, run my jobs, and delete the cluster to reduce expenses, while my data is persisted, safe in Windows Azure Blob Storage, and unaffected. My first decision on the storage screen is whether I want to use an existing storage account, create a new storage account, or use storage from another subscription. When I select Use Existing Storage, Azure auto-populates my account name and default container. The container is where my data is stored within my blob. The storage container will be used as my default file system. I can use the default container or create a new one. The default container in my existing storage account contains data that I want to analyze with this cluster, but I also want to use this cluster to analyze some new data that I plan to upload later, so I'll also create one new storage account. For my new storage account, I have the same 3 choices. This time, I'll create a new storage account and name it MHART. When I click the checkmark, it takes several minutes to provision the cluster. I know it's done when I see Running in the status column. My new storage account is also being created and shows online when that job completes. Dig into the cluster by selecting the HD Insight tab and then double-clicking the cluster name. For more HD Insight videos and content, please visit windowsazure.com. Thank you.